I love democracy. I love the Republic.
The main thing is to protect these characters, make sure that they still continue to live in the way that you created them, and that the universe of Star Wars continues to grow.
Everybody, it's Stephanie back at the cantina. To all my recent subscribers, welcome. Have a good time here. We talk about things outside of the Star Wars franchise and outside of pop culture that affects it. And this is one you're going to hear a lot about. I look at financials of Disney to see how healthy the company is, because ultimately that decides on what we get to see. And right now the financials are really bad. So I'm gonna talk about this lawsuit, talk about the financial cul-de-sac Disney is in and the trouble that Iger has found himself in. I'm gonna tie it into Lucasfilm. So here we go. So ex-CEO Bob Chapek and CFO, who is Christine McCarthy, are being targeted by a group of shareholders for what's going to be a class action lawsuit. Now, here's the rub. The rub is that you have to find a judge that's willing to turn it into a lawsuit like that. And that's kind of a difficult thing to get these things moving. So I'm using this as an example of what is actually happening with the shareholders. And this is just a little pension fund that's suing Disney. It's not Tim Buckley of Vanguard or Nelson Peltz or Dan Loeb of Treon or, you know, Rupert Murdoch. It's a pension fund. And the thing that you hope for in these, if it does go to trial, and I'm not saying it will, that upon discovery, a lot of Disney's financial shenanigans gets exposed. Reedy Creek does the same thing. There's a question about municipal bonds and regular bonds, and Iger at the investors call and at the quarterly earnings call said things out loud he probably shouldn't have had. But there's a feeling among the well-read, well-educated among the fandom that Bob Iger's return to Disney wasn't so much that he was needed to right the ship. It was because he got them mixed up with FTX and the cryptocurrency disaster. And if you remember that night, that Sunday night that Bob Chapek was unceremoniously dumped, that was a week or so after FTX filed bankruptcy. Okay, so Bob Iger's name was mentioned as an investor by, God, what was his name? Oh, I can't remember his name, but he was mentioned as an investor on CNBC. The man was cut off from saying any more. I don't think by law it's allowed for the news to put it out there until discovery, if there is a lawsuit, and with Sam Bankman-Fried being in jail and awaiting trial, it probably will come out in discovery who gave him the impetus to go and start this crap. And 2017 is when all this started. And Bob Iger, it looks to me, was a groundbreaking investor in FTX. But Fried would money launder for people like him. You got to remember, Iger wanted to run for president. So he needed a war chest. And there you go. It's perfect. So, yes, they are getting sued by shareholders. And this just goes to show how unhappy shareholders are. Okay. And this shows the fray in the trust for Iger even, period. And if it does go to discovery, it'll end up being a bad look for Iger. Bob Iger is the one that hired the woke folk. He went to Wokistan to hire them because he wants the Hollywood money, or wanted it for his presidential aspirations. And then he got Disney involved in FTX. He bought Fox, the Fox, 20th Century Fox Studios, and Searchlight Film, stupidly, for too much money. And it, ultimately, this is his fault that this is going on. And I think if this does go to trial, this class action lawsuit, that he'll be exposed as badly as the company. And, you know, I don't see how they could go after Chapek, but Iger has managed to smear Chapek with the bad when it was Iger's fault that did it. However, CFO Christine McCarthy, who is Iger's right-hand woman, is named in the lawsuit too. So this is going to come back at Iger's door, okay? This is something that's not going to just land where it lands. It's going to make him look bad. And there are other lawsuits going on too. We could talk about the Karen McCarthy lawsuit against Lucasfilm for egregious firing. And I'll get to that in a minute. But if you look at how bad we're theorizing Disney's financials are, and they're bad, think about how it affects Marvel, Pixar, and Lucasfilm, okay? And think about who's going to get laid off and how they can manage to save those companies without firing, without selling them.
There is a danger. Should I have your ship standing by?
Evacuate? In our moment of triumph? I think you overestimate their chances.
So here she is, resting bitch face. Kathy Kennedy is in a bad spot. And it's not just because of her own poor decision-making. That helps Iger and the board's decisions for her career at Disney, but it doesn't, it's not the only reason why that what's happening right now is happening, but it's the biggest reason why. If Lucasfilm had been run competently, the franchise respected the sequel trilogy, uplifting and protecting the characters, as Kennedy likes to say to George, and yet she lied about it. We probably would not be seeing Lucasfilm in trouble. It might be the only thing besides the parks that seems to be hitting on all four cylinders. Yet, there she is. Okay. Kamran Pasha has a connection to Lucasfilm, who has talked a lot about what's going on there. It's utter chaos. The last face-to-face meeting Kennedy had with Iger, she came out stony-faced. And I'm going to catch the newbies up on this. The reason why he was so pissed, because she didn't say a word about the meeting. In the last meeting that she had with him before that, she was looking for sympathy everywhere she could find it. And this time she walked out dead silent. So obviously it didn't go well. Disney wanted her to use Star Wars Celebration as her goodbye celebration. Not necessarily that she'd be saying, "I'm leaving, folks," but yay me, look at me. Now, everybody in Hollywood would know that that was a signal that she's leaving. Kennedy told Iger, "They'll know I'm leaving." And he basically said, "I don't care. We've got the press release packets ready. Do it." Instead, she did. She threw a temper tantrum, which is what happened at Star Wars Celebration. A temper tantrum. And she announced a new movie with Daisy Ridley, which after the financial news and this lawsuit ain't ever going to happen. And she had the folks from The Acolyte show up. And the outside world wasn't allowed to see the sizzle reel, but chosen people at Celebration were. And Kamran's contact, Sparrow, basically said there's nothing in the data banks that has Acolyte. Lucasfilm is being sued over the Acolyte. Karen McCarthy's lawyer basically said Karen McCarthy was watching Midnight's Edge, and basically she told her lawyer to talk to Kamran. Kamran talked to him, and because Karen McCarthy started to wonder, is The Acolyte even a real show? I have a theory that between the time she was hired and the time that Hedlund called her and said they didn't need her anymore, that Chapek, because it was back when Chapek was still CEO, and it was over a year ago now, Chapek told her, "No, we're not doing The Acolyte." And so they decided to do a sizzle reel with discretionary funds, and they couldn't have someone outside of the circle of trust being part of that if it wasn't a real show. So McCarthy was out. That's my theory. Okay, so we've got Leslie Hedlund marching out to Star Wars Celebration, and it's like, but can we see some of the footage? And we weren't allowed to. Okay. And it's like, okay, fine. So Leslie Hedlund now has a different show. She's show running for directing and writing called Night's Edge. And Leslie Hedlund is a lot of things, but she's not Greg Berlanti, and sure as hell is not Taylor Sheridan. So it's not like she can be a showrunner who commands other showrunners. So she can't do The Acolyte and Night's Edge. And Night's Edge is actually going to the other Disney studio, Freeform, to be made. So it looks to us that Disney offered Hedlund a way out of The Acolyte, and she's taking Night's Edge. You will find Black Pills who will disagree with that, because they need to have bad things in their lives, okay? They need to be negative. It's almost like a demonic possession at this point. But when I saw that she was going to Freeform and Night's Edge, I was pretty convinced that she's done with The Acolyte. You still see names that have been already added to IMDb Pro popping up for The Acolyte. But as far as it being a real show, we'll have to see. And considering all the mayhem going down now at Disney with the lawsuit. Does it make sense for them, with Star Wars being in such a shitty place, to allow a show that no one wants or needs, The Acolyte, to be fully funded? I don't think so. And it never was fully funded. So now I got the Daisy Ridley, Charmaine Obaid-Chinoy Rey film. No. No. It, again, with everything going down at Disney, from the cost cutting, the budget cutting, to the layoffs, it didn't make sense for this movie to happen anyway, considering Bob Iger himself said not that long ago they were going to slow down Star Wars movies and make sure it was the right one to make. The Rey movie is not. Damon Lindelof basically said out loud, I believe in Esquire, that Disney told him that basically the Rey movie wasn't going to happen, and they didn't need him there. And Stephen Knight was dragged in by Lucasfilm. This is Stephen Knight. He did Peaky Blinders, and he's now working on a William Shakespeare bio with his wife in England. And if you look at Stephen Knight's IMDb Pro resume, there's a lot of shit he's working on. Where's the Star Wars movie gonna go? Okay, so it looks to me, and the Star Wars show and movies for these people, and I'm talking Hedlund, Ridley, and Knight, these shows and movie were never mentioned in the articles about them going to Knight's Edge and to the Shakespeare bio, okay, which is a grave omission, okay, a grave omission, and it says a lot. So how does a lawsuit make this easier for Disney to say no to both of these? Very easy. Again, if in any way, shape, or form, and look, if the lawsuit with Karen McCarthy goes forward and it's, look, I've got the legal documents at bottom, and if it goes forward and Hedlund is in Lucasfilm and their shell company, Blue Stocking, is exposed, this is fraud, okay? They committed fraud, all right? Pure and simple. But I want you guys to hear that, because I am the only YouTuber that will mention the bigger picture, all right? I don't allow crying and complaining if you don't know the whole story. And the whole story is Disney's in too much of a financial mess to even consider these two bullshit, this show and this movie, because the fans don't want it. And it's good money after bad, okay? And one, The Acolyte, looks to me like it was never going to happen anyway. And they've been trying to do it, and if it gets exposed for being nothing more than a sizzle reel, all hell will break loose. This is Steph signing out. I'll see you around the galaxy.